The use of block and bleed valve or double block and bleed valves is mandatory in many industrial processes for isolating the measuring instrument from the process line. This allows maintenance work to be performed on the instrumentation without the need to shut down the entire operation. There are two approaches to the installation of a block and bleed or double block and bleed setup. Well, let's look at both together. We start with the conventional system. The conventional system connects multiple valves and fittings together to create the block and bleed setup that connects a process line to a pressure transmitter or pressure gauge. The double block and bleed isolation for the pressure transmitter or pressure gauge is achieved by using three separate valves between the transmitter and the process line. Such installations are common in many industries, including offshore and onshore applications, chemical industry, or petrochemical industry. As you can see, a conventional system produces a very large and bulky setup, which takes a lot of time to install, has a large number of potential leak points, and is relatively expensive to install and maintain. But there is a second isolation method, the so-called close-coupled installation. The close-coupled installation creates a direct, minimal link between the process and instrument by replacing multiple valves and fittings with an integrated instrument mounting product. This saves time and costs during installation and reduces the number of potential leak paths. By placing the instrument, such as a pressure transmitter or pressure gauge, closer to the process, the close-coupled installation is up to 60% smaller and up to 50% lighter than a conventional assembly. There are two industry standards for an integrated process to instrument product that integrate block, block and bleed, or double block and bleed valve functionality into a monoblock design. A distinction is made between monoflanges and slimline monoflanges. Monoflanges use ball valves on the isolation valve and can either use a ball valve or a needle valve for the vent valve. The valves are rotable, which is a good choice in potentially clogging service. The positions of the handles provide a quick indication of whether the valves are open or closed. Slimline monoflanges use needle valves on the isolation valve and the vent valve. Slimline monoflanges are typically used in clean service and are the most compact and cost-effective way to perform a pressure measurement. Slimline monoflanges can also be easily configured for high-temperature applications up to 550 degrees Celsius. But when to use a monoflange or slimline monoflange? We have summarized the most important features of monoflanges and slimline monoflanges for you in a table that should be considered when selecting the most suitable valve for a given application. Summarized, we can say that the closed-coupled installation helps you to overcome the problems of traditional assemblies on primary isolation duties, especially when space and weight are limited.